This is Cheeky Witch. I'm doing another Thrifty Witch kind of after Halloween assorted haul. I also went to like Walmart and Target. I actually got a whole lot of things after Halloween that I didn't tape. I may possibly choose to go and show you some more of my stuff. I need to do like an apartment type tour, but my apartment's kind of a mess at the moment, so I don't want to do it quite yet. Hopefully this weekend I might actually have a day off so I can clean my apartment. So if that happens, I will try to do at least an altar tour, like witchy area tour, maybe even an apartment tour. We'll see. Well, anyway, so I went to Savers today, and it is a Thursday, so I got 20% off everything because I still have my student ID card. So I got 20% off of all the prices. This basket is actually really like good sized and in really good shape. Nothing's damaged on it, and it actually has hinges. So I got it. It was originally $6 and I got it 20% off. I have some stuff sitting in here just to make it easier to get it out of my car. I went to Walmart to do after Halloween, but there was hardly anything there. I was hoping to get another one of the black skull candles, but it seems like everyone's out of those, but oh well. So instead, I got ribbon. This is a plain black, and I don't know if you can kind of tell, these are actually black lace ribbons. And these are normally, like, $1, so I got them half off for 50 cents. Which is a pretty good deal. I will say, watch the ribbons, because a lot of times they're the cheap plasticky ribbons that just tear and look like crap. If you can find ones that are actually like nicer ribbons, or like the lace one where it's more like a fabric, I would go for those. But I wouldn't necessarily go and get the patterned ones that are all plasticky unless you have a specific purpose for it. Here's more of the black lace. I really like the black lace one, and they had quite a few, so I got that. I also got black tissue paper because it was half off. Anything Halloween related, except some candy, which doesn't make sense to me, but whatever. So I got more black tissue paper because it was like 75 cents or whatever, so it was a lot cheaper. I also got the Halloween movie. I believe this is the first one. Maybe, hopefully, pretty please. I guess it's covered up, so I suppose it could be Halloween 2. I'll be sad. Yeah, it's Halloween 2. It's a lie, but oh well. I've been looking for the original Halloween, so I'm kind of actually a little bit irritated that this is Halloween 2, because I thought it was the original Halloween. But oh well. Not as good as the original, because I have the remastered version, or the remade, whatever one, and, yeah. Also at Savers for 99 cents, I got one of these Avon, chalices. I actually already have two of these that I got for $2 a piece at a different, at the Arc quite a while ago. I think I had them in a haul, and then I went to a little, like, random local little place, and I got three of these at the same time for 50 cents a piece. So I ended up buying a total of four today, and I already had two, so that's a total of six. I'm probably going to try to sell them on Etsy, maybe, or Amazon, I'm not sure. Because I really don't need six of these, even though they're absolutely gorgeous. But since they are hard to find, and they are in such good shape, and, like, for 50 cents, I'm like, I might as well just get all of them. And the worst that happens is I end up selling at least some of them. I'm definitely keeping at least one, probably one or two for myself. And then I have a friend who wanted one for her Hecate altar. Because they are a nice, like, small size if you don't have a lot of room for a ridiculous size. I might actually show you one that I found at Home Goods. I got an all black, really tall chalice at Home Goods for like $4. So I might pause this at the end and go over to my Hecate altar and show you a little bit of that so you can see that chalice. Hecate's altar is a little bit messy because I just finished doing a spell where I had something on the altar and I ended up taking it away and burying it. So I haven't reorganized her altar yet so that it looks decent. So it's a bit of a mess and there's a few extra things I've set on it. Next, I actually am super happy I found these at Savers. I'll actually open it up so you can see them. This is, oh gosh, it's actually a locket, but it's open in the front. I thought this would be good. I don't think I would necessarily put herbs in here unless I maybe made a little wax tart in there with herbs. But this would be good for some kind of, like, I don't know, some things that you want to have open so you can see in it. I haven't quite decided what I want to do with this, but since it was only 99 cents instead of $3, I figured I would find a use for it. I'd gift it to someone. By the way, if you're wondering what happened to my finger, I actually burnt my fingers at my job, or one of my jobs at Spirit, on a hot glue gun. So my fingers are all messed up, in case you're wondering. Also at Savers, I found, for 99 cents, this little pyramid with an eye of Horus on it. I'm not really big into, like, I'm big into studying Egyptology, but I don't, like, use any of their gods or goddesses, really. I do have an Isis statue, but if you found a really nice hand-carved, large Isis statue for $2 at a thrift store, I think you would buy it too, even if you don't worship her. So I do have some Egyptology type stuff, and I've always liked the study of the culture of Egypt and like the pharaohs and stuff, but I don't worship any of them. I don't follow any of the deities for them right now, but I couldn't pass it up for 99 cents. As well as an ankh for $1.99. I actually already have this exact ankh that I got on sale, and the silver version of this exact ankh. I think it's more of a gunmetal than a silver, but whatever. So this is actually my third one of these. So I'm guaranteeing I'm probably going to either use it in something that I'm going to make for a trade on one of my Facebook groups, or I'll gift it to somebody. Or something like that. And then this is just absolutely gorgeous for $1.99. It's a little scarab, winged scarab. And so pretty, it's so colorful. So for $1.99, that had to come home with me. And then this is seriously, I actually just watched Spaceballs with my friend for like Halloween. You can actually see me. For Halloween. Kind of, because he doesn't like horror movies that much. So we watched like Shaun of the Dead, Spaceballs, and Fright Night, which are kind of more silly shows instead of watching horror movies. But I found this at Savers. I really dislike the frame. I mean, I don't hate it, but I don't love it. I usually prefer like a matte black frame. So this may end up finding a new frame eventually. But it was only $3, and you can tell, even without taking it out of the frame, that this is actually an original movie poster. So, I could not let that go for $3. Get this out of the way. Then I got some after Halloween stuff. I didn't get a whole lot of after Halloween stuff. Like I said, everything's pretty much cleared out. I mean, at least of the big box. Like, I even went the day after to, like, TJ Maxx and Home Goods, and there was, like, almost nothing. I think I got, like, one or two things at each place at most, and a lot of the stuff that I got, like, at TJ Maxx wasn't even Halloween stuff. I think I got, like, Halloween towels and a candle at Home Goods. Like, that was, like, one candle. It was, like, one of two candles they still had left. And at TJ Maxx, I got, like, one Halloween candle. And that was, like, all of the Halloween stuff that I was able to get from those two places. I even went to thrift stores to try to find some Halloween stuff, and I didn't really find anything. I got one book, like a kid's book, that is super cute from Goodwill, and I got a set of camo pants and a shirt. The pants fit me perfectly. The shirt's a little bit too small where I can button it, but not, like, all the way. It's a little bit too tight because it's meant for to be a boy's top. So it's a little tight around my hips and around my chest. But I was planning on wearing it as, like, an open jacket anyway, so I don't really care. Back to what I bought today, though. I got some glow-in-the-dark nail polish, because this is, like, next to impossible to find the rest of the year, and I can't seem to find my old one, and I'm pretty sure it's gone bad anyway, because it is, like, a decade old by now. Pretty sure it doesn't work very well. And this is only, like, 49 cents or something, because everything's half off right now. So, I was just like, sure, why not? I'll have some. I also got this little witch's hat full of mini cookie cutters. There's apparently 6 in here. I'm assuming these are the shapes, kind of. Like a bat, a pumpkin, a skull, a ghost, a moon, a black cat, I'm guessing are the shapes. I already have one cookie cutter set that's like tombstones and cauldrons and stuff. I actually have 2 cookie cutter sets. I don't really know. I don't make cookies that much, but the main reason I wanted this, well, the pumpkin would be good for a few different things. But I really wanted this little moon one, especially since they're tiny. Like, you can kind of tell they're not very big. Because I thought that would be good for making little Espot cookies. Make little moon cookies. And they'd be nice and small, too, which would be cool. The only real... I actually didn't try this on, which is probably not the brightest of ideas, but whatever. It's an extra large, so I'm kind of doubting that it's not going to fit me. But it's a Hogwarts t-shirt. I don't really love this tie with, like, all the different school colors on it. Not 100% loving this school color situation. But the cool part about it is it actually has a cape. And I have another one that's a Slytherin-specific shirt that has a cape, but the cape is Velcroed on, which is a good idea so you don't hurt yourself. But this one's actually sewn in, which I appreciate because it makes it a lot less obnoxious, in my personal opinion, when you're wearing it, because the, like, little Velcro things, you can even feel them and they're just annoying. And it's a very soft, like, nice t-shirt. And it was only $8 because the original price, well, like $8.50 because the original price was $17. Everything was half off. So I decided to get that, and I believe that one was from Target. I also got at Target these Crayola Fine Line markers for detailed coloring. Because these were on sale from $17 to $8.50, so they're half off. And I've been getting into coloring a lot, and I have a lot of coloring books. I actually got a Day of the Dead, I think I showed this in a video, Day of the Dead and a crystal coloring book that I've been wanting to do, and I just don't have anything decent to color them with, because I want them to actually look nice. So this has, like, a whole range of colors, and I like that there's different shades of, like, every color, especially, like, there's different grays. And, you know, so if you want to actually make something look good, you have colors. Coloring for grown-ups. So, that was an amazing find. Then at one of the 2 little, like, hometown thrift stores that I went to, I got this shirt, which says Live Free on it. I believe this was originally from Target. Yeah, it's an exhilaration. So this was originally a Target shirt. But what I really like is it has this big, like, the whole back is lace. So it is see-through. You'd probably want to wear an undershirt with it unless you don't care if people see your bra. But it was just too cute, and I got it for $2. I also got from that particular thrift store, that was the one where I found the 3 Avon chalices for 50 cents each. I also found for 50 cents this jar of sand, which is from Padre Island, which means Father Island. By the way, if you don't know Spanish. I googled this quick when I was in the store. I haven't done a lot of research on it, but I guess it's in Texas, or just off the coast of Texas. Don't really know the details, but I don't have the ability to get sand from other parts of the world with any amount of ease, so having any sand from another place is kind of cool. And it was only 50 cents, and it's not so huge that it's, like, ridiculous to have around, especially since I'm probably not going to use it for very much, if anything, because I don't really have any way to get more, so I don't want to, like, use all of it. And then I got this candle, which was $1. Apparently originally from Kohl's. I like these, like, layered, especially the triple layer candles, like pillar candles, when I'm trying to do, like, long-term spells. I think I might have shown it in a video, I'm not sure, but I have one that's, like, white, and then, like, light blue, and then dark blue in, like, three layers that I'm gonna use for, like, a self-healing kind of thing, because I've had a lot of crap go on lately, just to do some more, like, healing work and have it long term. I thought this would be another good one for, like, healing, because you can use the light blue for healing, or, anything, I don't know, purity. Green to me is both, like, prosperity, which is, like, both financial, like, money, or health-wise, to have an abundance of something that is good. So that could be anything from good health, friends, whatever. I use green a lot in abundance, prosperity type stuff. So I figured this would be good for maybe a prosperity and well-being, or a healing, or something. And it's nice because it's a pillar candle, but it's not ridiculously huge. And then I actually am happy I found this. I found black birthday candles, which I do have some that I bought at Walmart ages ago for like 50 cents a pack. Walmart doesn't sell them anymore. They do not exist. They have not existed in like any of the Walmarts I've looked in. I've looked in like 4 different Walmarts. They don't exist anymore. And it's sad. So, if I find them, I buy them because they're like impossible to find. You can occasionally find them online. I haven't found anywhere that sells them at a remotely decent price. Or they're not actually all black, or they're like only black and white striped, or whatever. It's obnoxious trying to find black candles that are birthday candles for little quick spells. So I had to get that for $1.50. And then this was 50 cents. I don't really know anything about this, but it looked interesting, and it was 50 cents, so I was like, why not? And then they also had this picture frame, which is actually pretty nice. The only thing that's missing is the, like, cardboard piece that goes in there, which, whatever, that's not a big deal. I was gonna actually use that for a Christmas gift. And then I had to get I got this for, like, 30 cents. I know it seems kind of dumb, but I grew up loving Powerpuff Girls, and this is Mojo Jojo. So, I had to get him. And this is by far my favorite thing that I have found today. These are actually crystal. I believe they, like, from the banding, I'm guessing these are agate. Or, what do some people say? Like, agate or something? Whatever. I say agate. Deal with my life. It's fine. So I'm pretty sure, if somebody knows that these are something else or knows for sure they're agate, definitely comment and let me know, but I'm pretty sure these are agate. And they're $4.75 for both of them, which I love how this store clearly buys, like, all of their stuff from Goodwill and then charges a different price, which isn't necessarily always higher. I just find it funny. But anyway, these are in great condition. They're absolutely gorgeous, and it's a matched pair. So, I had to buy them. I mean, they're just amazing. I couldn't not buy those for how cheap they were. The last thing is that I went to the Asian market, and this is actually kind of a witchy tip, so you stay till the end for the witchy tip, because Asian markets, if you can't get to a witchy shop, or you don't want to spend a ridiculous amount of money, or anything like that, check out your local Asian shop. Also, you can get Joss money, which is the money that they actually burn for their ancestors. They use them at funerals or during, like, celebrations for their ancestors and stuff. Because they believe if you either leave them this money or burn this money, that they get it in the afterlife. I don't know. I haven't done, like, a lot of research on it. So definitely look into it. It's either called Joss paper, or Joss money, or hell money are the different terms that I've heard it called. Sometimes they'll, like, I'm surprised that the place I went to only had this kind. Like, I've seen other places that have had like more Asian style money, or just completely fake, like hell money. But you can actually use these for prosperity spells, for money bringing spells, for business spells, especially in the place of actual money, depending on if you have the ability to use actual money, or if you just don't want to destroy a dollar bill to make a money oil. I'm a full believer in the intention and the symbolism and what it means to you makes your magic, not the actual ingredients. So, like, you don't have to have this specific ingredient. If, like, this other ingredient has the same correspondence or means that to you, you can use it in that way, kind of thing. So you can use a representation of money to do the same thing as real money would do, and that's a lot cheaper. It was like $115 a pack for these, and there's like, I mean, look at that, there's actually a decent amount in there. And I know they traditionally burn them. I would still be kind of careful because they do come from overseas. And I don't know what the regulations are, but you should be able to burn these without, like, creating toxic fumes. It's not like it's plastic, it's just printed paper. So, yeah, I mean, I'd be careful with it because, like I said, it's from overseas, so you don't really know the quality control on it, but you should be able to burn them as well if you wanted to do, like, candle magic or cauldron magic. Another thing that's a good thing that you can get from Asian supermarkets for spell work are these little red candles. They do have white and like off-white ones too, but I think they smelt different and I don't know what exactly they smelt like. But this was $4, and I mean, look how many you get too. They're little bitty like chime kind of candles that are red. They're very strongly scented like rose. And not like a fake rose. They smell like rose water. Or like rose candies. If you've ever had rose candy that's actually made using rose like essence. They are amazing. Made in Thailand. I don't honestly know. Because this is kind of like in their incense and shrine section along with the Joss paper money. And they do have bigger ones. You get quite a few less. You got, like, I think 9 or something instead of, like, however the hell many this is, for the same price. So if you do want bigger candles, you can get bigger candles that are still scented like this. They're more like a traditional chime candle. They're probably, like, about that big around instead of being super tiny. Another good thing is if you can't find certain fruits or vegetables for something, like if you wanted to use a pomegranate, for instance, like in a Samhain ritual, super cheap pomegranate. I can't remember how much did this cost. Hold on. Pomegranate is $1.69 a pound, and I paid $1.67, so it was just under a pound. And you just kind of have to be careful of the quality, being, I feel like they're a little less regular. You can tell it's a little beat up. But I haven't had any, like, been stung too badly by buying from Asian markets. They do tend to have a lot more variety and unusual stuff that you wouldn't necessarily be able to get at a local supermarket, or if you do get it, it's super expensive, and honestly, Walmart's produce quality control is not that great, so whatever, it's about the same. So that would be one good way if you want to get a little bit different fruit. Also, they have a lot of different herbs that you can't necessarily get in a normal supermarket. If you get, like, a natural grocer's or something, you'll be able to find herbs, like, especially whole herbs, a lot easier. Or if you're lucky like me and actually have a little hippie shop that has, like, a whole wall of random weird jars full of herbs with all these handmade labels with hand-drawn pictures. Like, it's super cool. So I normally buy most of my herbs from them. Their prices are probably equal or better than anywhere else in town. And definitely better than any supermarket. And they're fresh, organic, ethically picked, and all that business. So I do normally get stuff from there. But they don't have everything, sadly. So this is actually flat cinnamon sticks. And I believe I paid like $2 for this. $3. So this bag was $3. They did have bigger bags for not that much more. I just know I'm never going to go through it, so even if I only spend one more dollar for twice as much, I would not use it, so it'd be pointless. But this is nice because it's the... There are two different kinds. Our American cinnamon is not the same as cinnamon. It's actually a completely different thing, in case you didn't know. This is actual cinnamon. Google that. You'll learn. So... That's one difference, but the second one is just the shape. It's not rolled up. It's a little easier to work with, a little easier to break up or grind. So, you know, nice for that. I also got fenugreek powder. I'm probably butchering the pronunciation. I don't know a whole lot about this, but I have heard it used by a lot of other witches, and I've been interested in getting some. And I just couldn't find any, and then I went and saw it there for $1.55. This whole bag was $1.55, and it's 7 ounces, or 200 grams. I think that means grams. And they have pretty good quality overall. I do know this is used in a lot of prosperity and money bringing, and I need some of that in my life, so, you know. I also got, they actually have dried lime leaves for $3 for, like, a little hand-filled baggie. So I got some of that because I do not have lime leaves or know anywhere else I can buy lime leaves. So I figured at least I'd have a little bit to work with. Everything else, these are actually kola nuts that I got for $1.99. Apparently you can eat these. I wouldn't guarantee that too much because I don't know anything about them. But I just thought they were interesting, never heard of them. I figured I'd use them magically anyway, so even if they're toxic, I wouldn't know any better. Who cares? The little bit of Googling that I did before making this video is basically what cola is derived from. They have caffeine in them. They're very bitter. So I suppose you could use them in energy work. Or something. I don't know. Google it. Apparently these are at Asian markets. The only other things I got were tons and tons of black tapioca pearls for making boba tea. And I wanted to try the original shrimp chips because they're supposedly amazing. And I've never had them. So I got some. I think that was it. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything else. Alright, well, you guys have a wonderful day, and blessed be. I will try to make some more not haul-related videos this weekend, because I actually have a few days off. Fingers crossed. Hopefully that works out. Alright, you guys have a great day. Blessed be. Bye.